brother or sends his stories. This is your favorite brother or from another mother or. Hallelujah. Here in the Philippines, we've been having lots of earthquakes. I wanted to share photos with you. I haven't done a slideshow in a while. We just passed our, was in the U.S., trying to bring revival by the grace of God. Do the ministry work there when we had our 7th anniversary of Joshua's ministry here in the Philippines. So praise God. This is some of the damage from the, we've had 3 earthquakes, like a 6.4. Then a 6.6 and a 6.8, something like that. They, you know, they'll downgrade a little bit afterwards. But anyway, we had 3 earthquakes all within just a close distance of each other. All 3 of them were close to me, close to all the different orphanages, all of our feeding programs, everything. Because all the ministry is spread out. As a matter of fact, the earthquake is kind of a central location between all of our different ministry areas. So this is orphanage number 2. Building number 1, the original building, the original house that was there when I bought the property to start the orphanages. This house was probably already 10 years old at that time. I don't know the exact date. So this is the oldest building we have. You see, this is there are some people that watch my videos who actually build bridges and stuff, you know, structural engineers. You can see that it's in pretty bad shape from the top to the bottom. And as for your prayers, We got to do something. We moved all the orphans from orphanage number 2 to orphanage number 1 temporarily. We basically condemned the building for now, but I want to get it repaired, and I have no idea what these kind of things is going to cost. But even Philippines is cheap, but it's not that cheap. And you know, I think we may end up having to knock down the wall or whatever. I don't know. But we have 4 buildings there at orphanage number 1 and number 2, and they all have damage. Orphanage number 3 has no damage, so praise the Lord for that. But this is the outside of orphanage number 2, building number 2. It's a different building. You can see it's got all these cracks. I'm going to go through this. I already did this video once, and somehow it got lost in the processing thing here with this free screen-o-matic. So hopefully it'll go through. So I'm trying, you know, once you know, I'm repeating myself and to me, but not for you. So. Anyway, this is some cracks. You can see anyone that wants to look at these pictures better, you can slow it down and look. These are more hairline cracks than the other buildings because the other buildings are newer. That first one is really old. These buildings are newer, so it's not as bad. We built all these in 2012, 2013, and 14. Still plenty of cracks. Look at this. Look at this. It goes all the way down to the foundation and all over here. This is... Back again, you can see this is that first building. It's got the worst damage. Orphanage number 1, number 2, building 1. This is on the outside. This is, you know, one of the other orphanages. Like I say, we got 4 buildings there in one compound. 2 of them are for orphanage number 1, and 2 of them are for orphanage number 2. They all have plenty of cracks. Plenty of cracks, damage. You can see... Crack. This is hairline cracks, not as bad as the other ones, but still, I mean, I don't know if it goes all the way through. Or I mean, it's on both sides, so I know they go all the way through. Some of them, the crack, you can see it here, then you can go on the inside and see the crack, same crack. So it goes all the way through. So look at this. See, it's cracked all the way through. This is orphanage number 1, building number 2. As this is back to orphanage 2, building 1, the original building. Can see, well, it's got paint, you know, that was painted when I bought it. So the other ones we never painted, we never had the budget to paint them. It takes a lot of paint when you're painting the cement here in the Philippines. You got to put lots of layers. It's probably more expensive to paint, I think it is, and then to put tiles on your walls if you want to do it right. So it's just crazy. Philippines paint is a very expensive for some goofy reason, but for why, I don't know. But anyway, they claim we had a carpenter look at this. He said the foundation he thought was all right. It's just the walls. It's just another wall in orphanage number 2, building 1. Look at all these cracks. It's all over the place. This is on the outside of one of the other buildings. See, look at that. Very bad stuff. More. Yeah, so as for your prayers, well, there's the orphans from orphanage number 3. There is a fairly recent photo from maybe a couple weeks ago going to church, coming out of the church. Anyway, I was just going to say I never raise money. You know, I just talk about it a little bit when I do a slideshow. I haven't done one in a long time. It's overdue. Like most people watching my YouTube channel don't even know that we have the orphanages, and many of them, you know, don't care. But that's part of the end times, brothers and sisters. The love of many waxes cold, but the Lord said a perfect religion is to keep yourself spotless from the world and you know, help widows and orphans. They're in the book of James. Use the Google and look it up. But anyway, we have Zell. You know, just like if you saw the news, there was a persecution of a famous street artist who's a conservative, and PayPal froze his money and took his money, froze it for 6 months, and then they shut him down. And they did that to a lot of conservatives, and they did it to us. Our PayPal was frozen and locked down for no reason. When they found out that I was a missionary in the Philippines and that I made Christian videos, they persecuted us, and that's what happened. No good explanation. And anyway, so we have Zelle, which is, you've got to go, if your bank is participates in Zelle, you can do it, and it's free, and you got to set it up. It's a little bit of a hassle once you get it going. It's fine. And all that information, how to do that, is below all of my videos. And then we have a Facebook group. The link is below the videos. Every video I make, we have a Facebook group, and there's, you know, I post pictures all the time like this in the Facebook group, and updates of what we're doing and all that with the orphanages, the feeding programs. So we feed about 1,000 kids a week and feed and teach them the Bible. Look at all this spider webbing cracks there everywhere here too. This is one of our, you know, this is all four of the buildings there. I'll be going there. Look at this crack right there in the corner. That's a serious one. I'll be going there. I'm doing an evangelistic crusade at Orphanage Number 1 next Sunday, and I'll be there and I'll make a video there. And I'll be doing, we're inviting people from all over. Since we've had all these earthquakes, people are open to salvation. So praise the Lord. It's sad, but true. Philippines is less than 10% born again Christian. And it's sad that it takes something like this, you know, and even in the States, it's the same thing. It takes a tragedy to kind of wake people up. Very sad, but true. So we should have a nice evangelistic crusade there at Orphanage Number 1 on Sunday. And I'll be making a video there of all the damages. Okay, so let's see some more. And like I said, I don't know what it's going to take to fix it. This is one of our feedings. That's Pastora Daisy. Some of the first ones I worked with when I did crusades and all that in the Philippines. And I came for the summer of 2005 and 2006. And I did crusades and medical missions and all this. And they're some of the first pastors that I met. So I've been working with them since 2005. So for 14 years, I've been working with them. There's their son, who is also now a pastor for about 10 years now, Pastor Joseph and his wife. And they do two of our feedings. Pastora Daisy and Pastor Raul probably do about 5 of our feedings slash teachings. There's Pastor Joseph's wife. See, they teach them, you know, little songs and read them Christian stories. And it's like vacation Bible school, you know, every weekend. See, there she is. She's got the little, we've got lots of story books. Praise the Lord. Somebody donated and we were able to get some in Manila. And we go to different outreaches area. We have 14 major feeding stations, and then we have all these little outreaches. And I just put random pictures on here. And I've got hundreds of pictures that I've never posted in the Facebook group. It's just too many. But about twice a week, I post a few pictures there of the orphans or the feeding programs in the Facebook group. And it goes all the way back to 2012 or 13, whatever it is. You can go on, 2012. Go on there and see all the pictures that you want to about it. This is another, Pastor Danny, whose wife, I got a picture in here of her, Pastora Jenny, who was killed in a motorcycle wreck. Doing one of our feedings, she was thrown off the motorcycle, hit her head on a rock, and died. But Pastor Danny was, there was a young woman, about 35. She had real bad diabetes, uncontrollable diabetes, and seizures. I prayed for her. She was healed. She was volunteering at Orphanage Number 1, kind of staying there because she was disabled. I prayed for her. She got healed, and I prayed for her to find a husband and all this and be healed, and she was. And she married Pastor Danny, the widower, and now she's there as the, you know, helping him with the ministry at the church they've had going for over 20 years. And this is that church, and I did a medical mission there, and this is the first deliverance I ever did was in this church. The first deliverance I ever did in 2006. There in the Philippines was in this church during a medical mission we had with some of the local pastors. And let's see. So let me go through this because this video is limited to 15 minutes. There's a great big old pot of food there. They're cooking and there some kids are being taught right there. It's one of the daughters of Pastor Raul and Pastora Daisy. And this is a school teacher that goes. There's Pastor Raul, one of the first people I've been working with. And this is a school teacher from the church that joined the church since we've been doing the feedings. Other people saw that were people of, you know, of means and local people who were professionals. 90% of the people didn't go past the third or fourth grade. And so anybody that's, you know, an educated person, they see what we're doing and they help us out. Kids still don't have shoes. Lots of kids with no shoes in these areas. And we do the boxes and give away shoes all the time. But there's just never enough. They get worn out. There's more kids coming along, more generation of kids all the time. So there they are serving the food. You can pause. I'm going to go through this a little bit faster so I get through all the pictures. I just put random pictures on here so you guys could see the different areas. Some feedings are huge. I didn't put, you know, the pictures of the huge groups at the feedings I've got in the Facebook group. You know, sometimes there's 50, 75 kids at a feeding. Sometimes there's only 20. You know, it depends. This is another church, a small church there that we started way back. And I mentioned that there was a lady that was a rich business lady. She had a business that was failing. She was asking me to pray whether she should sell the business. And I prayed and the Lord told her to sell the business and start a new business. Well, her new business became very prosperous and she asked me what I could do, what she could do to bless me. And I said, I want you to put electricity to some of these little churches, because these churches don't have electricity. They don't have to have electricity, but they wanted to have a guitar with a pickup. And so I said, you want to bless me, put some electricity to some of these little churches, which she did in these remote areas. And the people go there because they love to have, you know, they don't have electricity. So them to go and, you know, and experience electric lights is already pretty cool. So it's one thing that attracts people to come to these little churches in the middle of nowhere, believe it or not. And there's Pastor Joseph with some children there in the place where we put on the electricity. And there they are against the same place. It's a lot nicer now than when I first went there. It was just fish ponds around here before. And there was no, somebody's put a wall there around their land or something. It's built up a lot better than it was before when I first went there in 2005, 2006. And you can always go back and look at this. I got to get through it before I get to 15 minutes. But you know, pictures are worth a thousand words, and the orphans all look happy. And these kids don't look so unhappy, but we have some areas where we go the first time, and the kids look like so unhappy and so bad-looking for not eating enough. And we always help the elderly, too, and they're there, which I usually don't have pictures of them too much, but we help everybody. Anybody that comes to eat, we don't turn them away. There's the picture I put in there of Pastora Jenny, the one that was killed in the motorcycle wreck. And I've had been working with her since the beginning. Her husband is the one that is remarried now to the lady I prayed with that was healed, that was, you know, had been handicapped her whole life. And praise the Lord for that. And there's orphanage number 3, another picture of orphanage number 3. There's orphanage number 1 and 2. We have orphans coming and going. Some of them age out. This is one of, we've got just one left of our very original orphans, very first one. There's one right there that's left. All the other ones have left and aged out. Basically, there's Earl. He was one of our original 4 orphans. And then, that's it. The rest of them have come sometime since then. He's one of the very original ones. There he is, Earl. He's been with us since the first day back in 2012. And there's orphanage number 3. I've somehow have several pictures of them stuck in here. But anyway, this is some more feedings. More feedings. You can stop on any of these pictures and look at it more if you desire to. Okay, good. I made it back. Yeah, this is the second time I did the video, so I had to repeat myself. But praise the living God, brothers and sisters. I ask for your prayers about this. Like I said, I don't know what the total cost is going to be to fix all these stuff, especially these major cracks. I mean, like I said, I had to move the orphans from orphanage number 2 to orphanage number 1, so it's tight space. I got to do something. We got to get it fixed. And like I said, I'm going to guess. I'm praying that we need, I always try to keep it, you know, low, but we need, I'm going to say we need probably about 5,000 is my guess minimum to get all these things, you know, fixed up halfway decent. And it could be more than that. I mean, you know, to build a house totally in the Philippines is a lot cheaper in the States. I mean, you could build a house like our buildings, like say $50,000 where, you know, it would be $100,000 or $200,000 in States. But, you know, so we don't need that much, but we need to repair them. So that's why I kind of guess. But pray for us. God bless.